Welcome everyone. It's a very cold morning in Nairobi. I hope by the end of the next 15 minutes you'll be feeling slightly warm after the presentation. So my presentation is titled Advancing Informed Demand for the Kenya Livestock Insurance Program through Capacity Development. I'll give a brief outline of what the presentation looks like. We'll talk about KLIP, the Kenya Livestock Insurance Program. Then I'll talk about ILRI's or IBLI's role in KLIP's capacity development. Then IBLI's consumer education strategy, IBLI's past captive tools and approaches, then the latest captive tools and approaches. Then we'll have some questions at the end of the presentation. So just to know exactly what we mean when we say KLIP or the Kenya Livestock Insurance Program, it's a government-led IBLI product under the Ministry of Agriculture, Livestock and Fisheries. So how it came about is that as a result of IBLI's scientific research and being able to demonstrate that this thing works from 2010, the Kenya government got interested in providing such a product to the pastoralists in northern Kenya. And it has come with a lot of opportunities. Some of the opportunities we have out of this initiative is that we are able now to have IBLI implemented on a larger scale, because the government has been able to expand or create a window for expansion into other counties. So far, the product is actively operational in Turkana County and Wajir County. Initially, as IBLI, we were in Marsabit, we were in Wajir, we were in Isiolo, and then the government came in and added Turkana together with a fully subsidized product in Wajir, in the two counties. So it's a good opportunity for us as IBLI. Then we also have the chance to influence policy. Like we've always said that ILRI, you know, one of our key pillars is to be able to influence policy. And that gave us a chance for the government to be able to now, working with the ministry, have dealing with the main policymakers for the government to provide this particular kind of livestock insurance. We also have very strong partnerships. We are working with the World Bank, the Government of Kenya, FSD, and the insurance partners. Our role in this, as IBLI, our key role is to provide support, or rather be in the leader's seat in the adoption of IBLI on the larger scale through IBLI. And there are two things we do there. One is developing both awareness and education, and also building the technical capacity of the partners we are working with. Then the second one is take a lead role in contract design for KLIP. And if you look at what we have here, it's basically our proposed theory of change around consumer education for the Kenya Livestock Insurance Product, or generally for IBLI. So if we have proper training and monitoring, and we have our agents and promoters knowledgeable and motivated to convey accurate information, then we have pastoralists who have realistic expectations out of the insurance product. And then we have a trusted product out there. So we have increased repeated sales and increased sales over time. And with this, having these two particular roles played out very well by IBLI and in collaboration with the government, we are able to at least look forward and realize these two outcomes. So our capacity or our consumer education strategy has three levels. The first level is level number one is knowledge and tools for government and insurance industry policymakers. And the kind of tools we are creating here and our target is people in the policy positions, maybe governments, ministers, or directors in the Ministry of Agriculture and Livestock and Fisheries. One example, and I'll talk about it maybe later on, one example of a tool that we've developed is the rating tool. The rating tool, I'll explain how it works, But that is one. But the second level is knowledge, skills, and job aids for IBLI and KLIP sales agents stroke promoters. These are your, like, the TOT type of people who have the task of conveying this information to other people, including parcelists on the ground. Then the third level of is awareness raising for potential clients, mainly parcelists. And if you look at our strategy in the past, what we've been doing is, just before I get there, we've been working within these two levels. When we go out in the field, we've been holding trainings for the agents or the IBLI promoters, and also having awareness or education sessions for the client. So we've been traversing across the two. But we are trying to develop, or we are developing tools that are focused on enhancing this, the knowledge and skills for this level, so that they can be able to train this particular level. Talking about the past, what we used to have as our tools, we had various manuals. We had the frequently asked questions about IBLI. We had the training manual, this one here, for pastoralists and agro-pastoralists. Then we had this one, a poster from Ethiopia. We had this is part of the handouts that we used to have, the pictorials or picture books. But we found these to be a little bit too wordy if you're working with a community of, you know, illiterate and semi-literate people. So we changed, and we've moved from having more of text to less text and more pictorials in explaining how index-based livestock insurance works. So you can see what we have in 2015 has limited text. It's basically just you're able to have a look and depict what exactly is going on in the picture. So those are the tools we've been using since 2010 up to last year. And then we started making some changes. The latest tools that we have, these are the what we had. Remember, I talked about us training on both levels. So we have agents here, and we have pastoralists here. So we were cutting across the two, level two and three. But then we've now changed, and the latest tools we have in 2015, some of them, we have the M-learning, we have e-learning, we have an application called the IBLI Percentile Calculator. We have the KLIP contract design and rating tool, the one I talked about for the Ministry of Agriculture, Livestock and Fisheries. We have gamification and incentives. Then we have instructional guides. So what you'll notice as I present and I talk about these tools is that as IBLI, we are slowly shifting to more standardized tools that have less demands for our human support. And the reason is that as the product keeps on expanding and it's being implemented on a larger scale, the government is coming in the Kenya Livestock Insurance Program, we need to have tools that can be used by any other person anywhere without really needing the support of our team. Then also the tools should be highly replicable and versatile. So if, for example, someone wanted to use what we have in another region or in another county, for example, we were able to move the same tools to be used that were being used in Wajir County for Turkana County. It's easy for someone to change that and apply it in another setting. The same applies also in, what we are developing currently are tools that are very systematic in the application. So you have a standard way of using the tools when you have them in the field. So the first one we have is IBLI's gamified M-learning experiment. How this came about is that we used to give classroom-based trainings for the TOTs and for awareness creation for the pastoralists. But then also after the classroom-based training, we wanted to create an opportunity for the promoters or the agents out there to learn more about index-based livestock insurance in their own environment. So this M-learning app is called Pocket IBLI. It's called IBLI because it's Sharia compliant. So it is index-based livestock takaful, but it's the same product. And we worked with one of the insurance companies to have these practice like tiny modules which are learned, used through the phone. So if you are an agent, you are sitting at home and you have your phone, you are able to use or to go through some few sessions, then answer some quizzes and be able to send or submit your answers to a central server. And so there are some incentives in being able to get all the questions right. There are also some, you know, like if you can't get all the questions right, then you can't move to the next level. So that's creating a competitive, you know, incentive for someone to want to learn on their own. So the risk maybe is such games are very good and exciting, but you have to be, you know, they have to be executed properly. So in the next phase, as you can see, we will try to improve the mLearning app and enhance gamification components to include complementary education clips. Then the next one we have is the index-based livestock insurance percentile calculator. So these are screenshots, and it's an application, it's a phone-based application. And what you get from, so what you get from that phone-based application is that it's very, we realized it was very difficult to explain how we use satellite images or NDVI values to be able to know the levels of forage scarcity and be able to get to the value or the amount of money that the pastoralist will receive as their payout. So what is the best way? And the people who experience the biggest challenge are the ones who go to talk to the pastoralist. So they wanted something they can use to demonstrate how this is done. So with their phones, with this application, you are able to get all the NDVI values for your index unit or your division. And as you go around explaining how IBLI works, and someone asks you, so how are you going to convert all these satellite things you're talking about, and finally know how much we will receive as pastoralists in this village or in this division in terms of our indemnity payout. So the trainer or the promoter can easily, after having installed this application, he gets regular updates, 10 days updates of the NDVI values for that particular division, and it's automatically able to calculate the percentile ranking for that particular division and the percentage payout. So you see, for example, you have slide one, where we have, I mean, screenshot one, you have the NDVI values for that particular unit, it's called Banisa, for example, during the long rain, long dry season of 2015. And when you enter the NDVI values for each decade, every 10 days, then you are able to get, you know, you have your latest update for, say, 2015, July 30th. And you want to know how much payout will probably, how is the season faring on? What are the levels of forage scarcity? And how does the season look like for pastoralists? Are they going to get payouts, or is it going to be a season without payouts? It will give you the percentile ranking and the percentage payout. And so you have zero payouts here, which means that that particular division does not qualify for a payout. And it's easy for a pastoralist to know that when it looks like this, the colors, even without knowing how to read and knowing how, you know, when you talk about percentages and percentiles, this orange color means there's no payout. When it's black, which means it's below the 20th percentile, then there's a payout for that particular division. So with this one, we've been able to use it or try it out because it's still work in progress, but there's there are disputes that arise where pastoralists say, we think we deserve the payout, but in reality, they didn't deserve a payout. So there's no payout for them, they're disappointed, they're disgruntled, and they're really arguing it out, you know. You can actually go back historically. It provides you with the historical payouts for that particular division for the last 14 years. So you can get the data and show them. Can you probably compare this particular season with any other season that was so bad in this particular area that you think will have deserved a payout. And if, say, they choose 2010 or 2008 as one of the years that had the worst long rain, long dry season, we go back to 2008 and get the calculations for that particular season. And you can easily compare and ask them, okay, fine, 2008 is correct. There was a payout, or there was supposed to be a payout in 2008. But this particular season does not look exactly like 2008 because there isn't a payout. So that's how we use the tool in trying to at least build the trust of the pastoralist in the product, and also be able to explain difficult concepts for them. Then we have the Kenya Livestock Insurance Design Tool, which is an Excel-based tool for capacity building for Kenya's Ministry of Agriculture, Livestock and Fisheries. And it basically focuses on the level one. If you remember when I talked about the level here, there's the level one where we have the policy makers. And these are the people who decide if we are going to, for example, the Kenya Livestock Insurance Program decided to insure 5,000 households in Turkana and Wajir. How many livestock units, for example, are we going to insure for each household that we've selected? And how much money do we have? And if we're going to select, how many people are we going to select in each of these areas? And which areas are we able to cover? What is the population of Turkana compared to the population of Wajir? Those are the decisions you are able to make using this particular tool. So maybe if I can just open that in... Okay, I wanted to open that hyperlink so that you can look. But there are some seven actually, key parameters that are looked at. The first one is the geographical coverage. So as a policymaker, you have to decide where are you going to cover. Is it Turkana? Is it Wajir? Is it Mandera? All those units. Then the next decision you have to make is the temporal coverage. At what point of the season are we going to be paying people? There are circumstances where at the slightest feel of forage scarcity, people would want to be paid. So are you going to pay them at that point? Or are you going to wait until things are at their worst point so that you pay? If you're going to pay early, then it means that the cost of insurance is higher because it pays very early. At the slightest feel of forage scarcity, you are paying. How much money do you have to do that? It's very expensive. Then the third one is about the trigger level. So at what point does it pay? Is it when the drought is at the 20th percentile, below the 20th percentile, or is it going to pay below the 15th percentile? At what point do you begin paying? Then the fifth one is about the premiums. They are very tiny. I don't know if they can be read. So currently, the Kenya Livestock Insurance provides a 100% subsidy, which means that of the 5,000 households that have been selected, for the number of TLUs or for the number of animals that the government is insuring for them, it's free, 100%. So there are circumstances where you will say that the household will pay, say, 20% or 50% or 30% of the total cost of insuring their livestock. Then the other one is the sum insured, which is basically the cost of the insurance you have. If, say, with the insurance company, for example, which is also part of the policymakers, because we have the policymakers as insurance companies and other stakeholders, including donors, if they decide that they're taking a risk worth, say, 60 million or 50 million, then they have to decide how they're going to do it. So this is the list of the things that you can do using this tool. Then we have the instructional design materials. As I had mentioned earlier, we started working on materials that are, you know, standardized and interactive so that they can be used and applied by any other person except our team, the IBLI team. So we've been able to get a better analysis of the learning needs of the people we deal with, and to systematically improve the materials and delivery methods that we use. So the instructional design guides are basically manuals that you use in a classroom setting to train on index-based livestock insurance. And they are systematical because you have the first lesson, the second lesson, the third lesson. And they include practical sessions, they include quizzes, they have tests, and all that. So that we are able to understand exactly how good our materials and how much, you know, how much are people gaining from the training. But also, if you are dealing with people who probably after the classroom training will not get any opportunity or another opportunity to go through the materials, then we've developed an e-learning modules where we are going to put the materials and people can be able to watch the videos and take quizzes at their own time, at their own pace, and be able to understand the index-based livestock insurance code. So this is just an example of the instructional design guide. This is a screenshot. We have the questions, and with the questions you have actually, like, during the session, people can use what we call clickers, and they answer questions in real time. So if you have a class of 40 people, everyone will click, and you'll know what percentage got how many points. And you can tell that out of 40 students, 10 have not gotten the concept. We have animations on just basically how the satellite works. We have a few role plays, and then we have, you know, like pictorials that we use during the session. That's the end of my presentation. So.